Rochester met with City of Rochester, specifically the city lawyers. We stated that we thought that we fulfilled the terms of our agreement, which we have with the city, for a permanent 24/7 occupation in Washington Square Park, and there was agreement on that, and agreement will be renewed. The city also seems very, very strongly feels that they want us to provide an end date. Maybe not fully understanding the nature of the protest, monumental social change. I mean, you know, we've got so many active working groups going on, you know, around the environment, urban agriculture, electoral reform, housing, worker justice. The work is being done, and if anything, we can kick it into even higher gear. The city itself has to act as well, and not just on First Amendment issues, but on economic human rights issues. And we have a long way to go, and we really are just at the very, very beginning of addressing issues of food accessibility, homelessness, health care, and really people's power and people's voices being stronger than the voices of corporations. We can provide ourselves electricity through generators which have been approved by the fire marshal. What we'd like to do is plug into the city electricity here, like is done in Buffalo, and they just said that they would get back to us on it. If the city continues to be adamant about, you know, they really want this protest to come to an end on their terms, then, you know, certainly we have legal remedies. You know, we have basically an enforceable contract. The way it's written is that it'll be renewed automatically if the agreement's met. And it's a populist movement. It's a public battle that the reasons they're giving, I don't think, are completely genuine, but that's okay. I think we'll continue to build the movement, and I feel like hopefully we'll come to a point where everybody sees the necessity of opening up public spaces like this for permanent dialogue and protest, and that this is part of the process of social change, is reclaiming public space. Occupy Nigeria, which has just exploded since January 2nd, and the whole country, whole economy is in paralysis. I think today is the second day of an indefinite general strike against the cutting of fuel subsidies, which is hinders poorest people in Nigeria. People are fighting back in a major way. This Occupy movement shown it has international breadth, depth, and endurance. And that's what we're going to need to make fundamental transformations.